The Philippines' Olympic boxers are back following their impressive performance in Tokyo. President Duterte congratulated them during a virtual meeting where he pledged a 2 million peso cash incentive each for silver medalists Nesthy, Petecio and Carlo, Paalam. The president also promised to give bronze medalist Unir Marshall 1 million pesos. Boxer Irish Magno came home without a medal, but she will still receive 200,000 pesos from the office of the president.
It is not an everyday occurrence that we receive such an honor from our citizens of the Republic of the Philippines. Those who participated in all events brought honor to the country, irrespective of I do not care about winning, and that is why they will receive 200,000 pesos, all of you, or other Olympians will receive from my office.
President Duterte says a local government unit in Metro Manila will no longer have the power to distribute cash aid because it lacked an orderly distribution system. Duterte went on to slam the local leader, mentioning supposed past lewd actions.
May isa akong siyudad dyan na hindi ko bibigyan ng power to distribute ayuda. Simply because in so many instances, they cannot organize. Wala, talagang every time, hindi lang tayo pwede magsalita ng politiko dito. Pero yan, kayong mga Pilipino, huwag kayong magpaluko dyan sa mga pandrama, magsalita, pati kung nakita ko nga sa Facebook kanina, lahat ng nakabikini ang gago. Tapos may isang picture pa doon na sinisilip na yung ari niya. Yan ang gusto ninyo. Ang training parang callboy, naghuhubad, picture.
The broadsides appear to be directed at Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, who is a possible 2022 presidential candidate. Last week, pandemonium ensued and vaccination sites in Manila, following fake news, unvaccinated people will not be allowed to go out or won't be given aid during the two-week lockdown. President Rodrigo Duterte is considering talking to Congress about giving tax relief to manufacturers of medical-grade oxygen. That's as the government stocks up on supplies amid rising COVID-19 cases and the threat of the Delta variant. The Food and Drug Administration, meanwhile, assures the public the country has currently enough oxygen tanks to meet the demand.
It is really goes out of control. We would need all the oxygens that they can produce. If everything is in order, bigyanin nyo na kaagad, and yung manufacturers, maybe we will, I'll talk to Congress, bigyan kayo ng tax relief dyan sa ginagawa ninyo, for you are producing a very vital component in the fight against the COVID-19 and the variant Delta.
Sa buong bansa naman po, kapuluan, meron sa Luzon, sa Visayas at saka sa Mindanao. And so far po, hindi naman tayo nakakakita pa ng shortage dito po sa ating oxygen supply.